There must be more carriages fired at wood pigeon in this country than at all the other game birds and animals put together. Most people start their shooting careers on pigeon. I did. There's almost always some farmer around who has been pestered by pigeons, and if you approach him right, you'll get a shot. Today I'm in Hampshire as the guest of the most famous pigeon shooter in the land, Archie Coates. Archie's been a professional pigeon shooter since the 50s, and to make a living at that, you've got to be very, very good. He used to average over 20,000 birds a year protecting crops for a large network of farmers. He's got hip trouble now and needs crutches, so he's down to about 10,000 per annum. 10,000. I don't think I've seen that many, let alone shot them.
One pigtail foil.
It's a big one as well, Archie, isn't it? Is that a point of yours that you always put your bale hides on the top of the hill?
Well, it's not exactly on the top, because in fact, behind it there is the A30. So you can't be too close to that, because
no, we've got a motorway at the back of us here.
I know, it's rather like that in this part of the world, I'm afraid. You very rarely get a place where you're completely away from traffic of some sort. Now, the reason it's there is a twofold. One, that one gets the decoys out on a brow, which is a good thing, i.e. they're easily seen. And the second is that I happen to know through years of experience, because I mean, I've shot this gun now for over 30 years, that the return flight, when they poof off in that direction and they're coming back, it comes give and take where the bale hide is. That is the line of flight.
So it's important that you know the flight lines before you set up your bale hide.
Absolutely. You've got to know the flight lines and reconnaissance. Well, there are two sorts of reconnaissance. And the first one is to find the field that they're actually feeding on. And for that, you must know your cropping. By that, I mean what the farmers are planting and when, and the sort of things the pigeons want to eat. So peas are obviously good news for pigeons, sort of caviar, if you like. Although beans, in fact, are, I think, better still. And so when you know that they're planting them, that's where you've got to look. The bale hide is there, but it's nice for the wind today, because the wind is in fact at our, will be at our backs, which does make it easier. But more important still, when you sight a hide, is to put it under what I call the pigeon traffic. Anything that comes in from that direction, which is a flight line, and from that direction, which is also a flight line, should, hopefully, see the decoy.
Pigeons could be feeding on anything, so bale hides are not the only kind Archie uses. You've got to be adaptable in this game. He can build a hide almost anywhere, like in this hedge, for instance.
I've used this hide before. It's an ordinary hedge hide, but I thought I'd show it to you just to give you the main points of a hedge hide. First and foremost, people are very inclined to make a sort of palace, a fortress, straight away. And they build it up and they build it up, and A, they can't see out of it, and indeed the pigeons can't see them. But the whole point of a hide like this is that you should be sitting down and looking through the cover, not over the top. It applies to any hide. Well, I tell you what, if you like to go and get behind there, you'll find one of those
tins. I see what you mean. You're dead right, yeah. You're right. You can see right through it.
You can see through it, but as long as you keep still, the pigeons won't see you. And also, there's another reason for not making an enormously grand hide straight away. You can be wrong. I can be wrong, and often am. Therefore, you may have to move.
How long would it take you to make one of these with one of them? A couple of
certainly
minutes?
Certainly not more than 3 or 4 minutes.
Yeah, I should think so.
But, of course, again, there's one thing I haven't told you. Obviously, one has to be a bit careful of what sort of timber you cut. I had a young man out some time ago who knew quite a lot about pigeon shooting. And I put him down and I said, well, make your hide somewhere in this area, because he knew enough for me to not to tell him exactly where. And at last, he went and cut 4 young beeches, beech trees.
Oh, that's...
So that's bad news. So you have to be rather careful. Now, what you've got, this hide is made of elder, which is no valuable, and very easy to make hide out of, and also for the sticks for putting the pigeons on.
When there is no cover at all about, then a net hide is the only answer.
Now, there's only one thing about a net howl. You can put it up against a fence like we've got here, some sort of background. I've used them under an ordinary telegraph pole in the middle of a field. But what I don't think you can do with it is to put a net hide in the middle of a field all on its own and expect pigeons to come into it.
You want this, just take this out and get it?
Yes, it's feasible, and then you can alter it when you get inside, you see? To the third, you get it to the right, but you must be able to look through it as opposed to over the top. That's vital.
Oh, yeah? That looks good?
Yeah. Well, thank you. As long as you keep still.
What about the background? We put a bit across the back?
We've still got another net there. A great big, enormous job. And that we have to put behind you as high as you can possibly get it. Because again, your background ought to be higher than your front. That's fine. That's him. There's nothing wrong with that at all. The other one you can keep spare for what I call eventualities.
That looks pretty good.
And you've got the same tin, but it may be too high for this particular situation. You may have to sit in it sideways, like you were, and lay it sideways. Yeah. But the point is that you must be able to look through the hide rather than it.
Now for the real thing. I've never had much success decoying pigeons. I usually shoot them flighting into woods, so I'll be interested in Archie's layout. One obvious difference is that he uses dead pigeons rather than artificial decoys. But then he has an endless supply of dead pigeons. They do look a lot more natural, but there must be more to it than that.
Present the picture which the bird is expecting to see coming in to feed in its chosen field. And that is what we're doing now, presenting that picture. And it's got to be right. In the old days, it was rather easier to present a picture. I have actually done it with insoles from a gumboot. But nowadays, pigeons are a little bit more, sophisticated. And you've got to get it right. And you've got to keep it right. So they've got to be, give and take, 35, 30, perhaps sometimes 40 yards away from the hide. And there's a good reason for that. We're using 6 or 7 shots, which is the normal one one uses for pigeons. The pattern is at its best at give and take 35 yards. So if the pigeon comes in over your decoys and you know it's there for 35 yards away and you go and miss it, it's not the fault of the cartridge.
Nor the pigeon.
Exactly. So therefore one uses, and therefore when we're in the hive, we'll let the pigeons come in over the decoys and we know that we're in the right place. And we're going to put these four right up almost to the edge of the field. Now what will happen is that, particularly for the birds that are coming from behind, they'll see those, they'll swing round into the wind, and it is pigeon etiquette, apparently, to fly over. No, not to fly over, to overfly. Their pals land on the other side. So if we do that, and they keep on going that way, there's your hide, you've got a nice, easy chance.
They overfly their pals?
You won't find them. They do land outside sometimes, but a lot of them would actually overfly.
So what you're doing is making a nail which leads them into you?
Absolutely. And I also do another thing. I don't do it so much now, but I have done it.
Just set this one up.
I leave a hole in the middle of the decoys, which I call the killing ground. Very nasty expression, but it works. Because there are no other pigeons overfly, so they're natural to make for the hole. We have, in fact, got one, as you can see.
Yes, in the middle
there. There's a space of ground. That's why I put the sack down here.
So when the pigeons come in, they would see a group there, a group here, and they would go for the...
Oh, well, I'm going in the middle. It's straight in front of your hide. Bonko.
Bonko.
Very nasty, this pigeon shooting case, isn't it?
Coming in lovely. A little left and right here, Archie, with a little look. If they swing in this way. One.
Good girl. Get on. Get on. Get on. Baba, get on. Good girl. Good girl.
She knows, she knows the one.
Isn't it amazing that she's gone straight to the one?
Come on then. Good girl.
Gone straight to the one. I wonder how she knew that.
Well, she's picked up.
I mean, she couldn't scent it, could she?
I hate to think how many poor things she's had to pick up in her lifetime, so she's picked up quite a few. Come along.
Yeah. Come on, Baba. Yeah, dead. Dead.
Well, what we've got to do is, having got into the hide and put the decoys out, one hopes in the right way, is to kill some pigeons and see if they're coming in, and then build up your picture. This is very important, the compound interest side of it. The more you get your gun off, the more you kill, the more you put out, the better it gets.
He's on the ground.
He is. Well done. Should have been two.
There was quite a few there, actually, yeah. But they were coming in.
Never mind. They'll come.
We're in a line of flight here, obviously, which you spotted and put out. If I was to pick a line of flight on what we've seen while we've been sat here, I would have said right in the middle of that main road down there. Everything seems to be crossing over between two trees right over the road.
I'm sure, exactly, but there just happens to be a little law in this country who may not shoot within 50 or whatever it is yards of a main road. Got him. Well done, you.
Might surprise some people to find that there are people who are professional pigeon shooters like yourself.
Well, not very many, I don't think. I mean, there may have been one or two others, but I don't know that there are. There was a chap in the Midlands at one moment, but I think he packed it in rather wisely. It's what I might call a labour of love rather than a financial success. Bonanza, exactly. A way of life, if you like. It's rather like dealing with the small shoot side of it, which I also do. Something you're keen on, something which you've taught yourself or have been taught by other people. But pity you didn't get that one. Yeah, it was a good one.
thought I might have got him, Archie, but I didn't. I heard.
You get him?
What's the most you've shot in a day? You did mention it before. Was it 500 and something?
550.
550.
But that was too many, and I never want to do it again. In fact, I would have been completely incapable of doing it again, A, physically, and B, mentally, because I wasn't physically tired, because I was much younger in those days. But I was mentally very tired indeed after it, because it was quite a strain, firing, I think, about 650 cartridges and killing 550 pigeons. But I would have killed a good 100 more if I'd been able to get more cartridges. I ran out twice. And then I had to take the dog, which is this one here, Baba's great-great grandpa, I think, I'm not certain, but called Simba, anyway, out of the hide, which was a bale hide, because he got shell shock, literally. And I mean, I've fired so many shots at him, he's sort of lying at the bottom of the hatch.
Would it not be exhausted going to fetch the pigeons?
Hmm?
It probably was exhausted going to fetch
the
pigeons.
Well, I didn't hardly bother that day. Three quarters of the way through, the whole field looked as if I'd been plucking chickens. It was white. And they took no notice whatsoever.
That's the feathers?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've always understand that, you know, when you dress a pigeon to put it out, and you put it down and you peg it out, that all the loose feathers around one picking up. You say it doesn't matter?
Quite. No, that's
well, I'll listen to you.
Another old wives' tale, I'm afraid. I promise you, it simply doesn't matter. They couldn't care less about the feathers. And that day, it looked absolutely white. And they took no notice whatsoever. And the last sort of three quarters of an hour, because after all, it was January, don't forget, I took the two front bales down and just sat right in the open, and they still came in. So I wanted to test it. Yeah. A little far, but not all that far. He took...
Ah! Don't tell me he's in the corn.
Here's the first one. Stuff,
yeah. Attaboy, very nice. That's the nicest shot you've done today.
Oh, I can shoot them when I want.
Good shot.
Amazing dog, this goes exactly the right one, you know. How old is she?
She's getting on. She's 9 and a half now, which is long getting on for a dog, you know. She's pretty fit, though, and well, she's jolly lucky. She probably does more work than most dogs, or more than any dog in Great Britain, I should think.
She's like all good Labradors. She just does it very steadily and sedately.
Yeah, so she's...
No aggravation. Go on. Come on.
I think that's not going to fall on your nut.
Dead, 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 dead.
Drop
good
it back.
Girl.
Get out, get on. Back, get on. Yeah, gas. Yes, that's the one. Good girl. Da-da. Yeah, well, we will. Yeah.
Come on.
Come on,
girl. Good girl, dead. Dead. Good girl.
I'll get that one in the corner of the dog.
I know where it is.
The damage that pigeons do to crops in this country runs into millions of pounds every year. The severe winter of 1962-3 reduced the pigeon population, but numbers have increased steadily since then. Our countryside with its nice mixture of arable and woodland seems to favour the wood pigeon. We certainly have far more than they have in Europe. Good for the shooting man, but lousy for the farmer. The pigeon succeeds because he'll eat anything. Wheat, barley, rape, clover, brassicas, even turnip tops in hard weather. He's seldom stuck for a meal. In areas where they're shot a lot, pigeons are becoming a real challenge. They're getting very smart. You've got to work at it to succeed, or else get an expert like Archie to show you how it's done. We've not done badly, about 20 in half an hour. And they're still coming in.
Come here. Now, what I'm going to do is, when these pigeons, as they are all too often, bypassing you, right or left, I'm going to chuck a pigeon out of the hide, simulating, although we're not in a net, a hide, or a hedge hide under a tree. I'm trying to simulate a pigeon dropping off a tree to feed with its pals. It is a bit complicated, but you've got to do it at the right moment. And the right moment is simply when the bird you throw, not yourself, but the bird you throw is not backgrounded. Now, if you can imagine yourself in a hedge, in a hedge hide or a net against a hedge, and there's a high hedge behind you, or edge of a wood, or whatever you like, and the birds are coming, bypassing you on the way out to your left or to your right, if you throw the pigeon then, it's no good. They can't see it because there's background. But if you wait, they've almost gone out of your sight, just as they cross the hedge you're in, and then throw it, the movement will catch their eyes, and they will then turn in and come into the decoys. Not always. Not always, by any means, but it's well worth throwing, and I tell you when it works particularly well is with young and foolish pigeons in September and October.
Well, there's a few up on the left. If you throw one out, well, we may just see.
Right. I can't see them,
coming up, coming up the side up there, look.
Just a lob, like that.
Well, they're coming this way, whether they saw the bird or not, I don't know.
Here you are.
Missed it.
Yeah, the boy was sitting in the decoy.
I didn't see the one sitting in the decoy, but I was watching the two coming in.
Well done, Jack. You got him?
Yeah.
Bah! There you are. Get out!
I'm coming round, coming round.
Yes, you will. Right. Yeah. Bah! Here. Here! Nowhere out there, you silly old cop. Girl, steady now. Steady now. I got you. I see that one.
Baba. Two.
Two?
Aye, but he's gone off under the field, that one. It's all right, it won't affect the dog. The dog will not bother me.
Come on, then.
Right high.
Papa, one for me and one for you.
And these are cooked in orange?
They're cooked in a sort of sauce made with orange, yes.
Look delicious.
And there's spuds and cauliflower.
A little cauliflower.
If you like, I should advise you to have a little bit of this rowan and apple jelly, which is, goes very well with it.
Rowan and apple jelly?
Yeah.
Let me try this pigeon.
You try that now, Jack. See what it's like. You better say it's good, otherwise my wife will shoot you.
Well, if I said... Superb.
It is good, is it?
I don't think they would believe me, but it actually is. It's beautiful.
Good.
It really is.
I'll only take one spud. Good for my figure.
Archie, how many pigeons are shot in Britain a year, do you think?
Well, I'm not absolutely certain, I'm afraid, but my guess is around the 2 million.
2 million?
And that may be an underestimate, because only a few years ago, I believe that actually 2 million were actually exported. So obviously there were a lot more shot.
That's a hell of a lot of good eating.
Mm.
Well, and yet you very rarely see them on the market.
Yes, but you see a lot of the... The eating is in what might call the cooking thereof. And if they're cooked properly...
Do you mind if I use my fingers?
They're perfectly good. But pigeon pie can be very good, but it isn't the sort of real way to eat pigeon.
I can't think of a better way than this.
Roger.
Cheers
to us.
Cheers, Archie. Cheers. Thank you very much. It's a lovely day.
Oh, yes.
Lovely day. That's terrific.